Then the next thing is ability to communicate clearly. In your lecture, you must put information across in a clear, understandable manner. You must be capable of reducing knowledge to its simplest component. It is very necessary, because if you will not reduce the knowledge to its simplest component, if you will not be original while you are teaching, student will not get any interest in your lecture. Because students has a lot of information, as we have information on the Google, through the books, and through many places. We have the YouTube lectures and so many things are there. So why the student will attend your lecture? They want to attend your lecture so that they can get something extra. When you teach through example, when you teach by the case studies, when you teach by using the problem solving ability, when you reduce the knowledge into simplest component, then only the student will get interest to come to your lecture. Try to tie the information track together. Don't teach randomly in an unorganized manner. Whatever you are teaching, it should be well connected. Relate theory, principles, etc. to the practical applications. Answer questions completely and freely. It is not necessary that you give your reply to their questions there itself. If you are feeling difficult to reply to their question, be frank to tell them that you will reply to this particular query in the next lecture, and should be punctual in replying to that query in the next lecture so that the student feel confident about you. Give feedback regularly and in a manner which helps the student learn. It is very necessary to give the feedback to the student, and your feedback should be positive instead of the negative feedback, because it motivates the student. If whenever you give the positive feedback, it motivates the student to learn and to gain the faith with you. Next is be prepared and organized. Plan for the semester, plan for the unit, plan for the week, and plan for the day activities looking to the virtual classes scenario. Provide PPTs. Again, this is a very important point. Provide PPTs, class note, etc., mentioning proper examples. Important points to remember. Good analytical questions for enhancing their problem-solving skills and special requirement, if any, to the student well in advance so that students can come prepared for your lecture. I know if we have any of the faculty members who share their content prior to their lecture to the student. Anybody? Anybody share their lectures or
yes,
content
sir.
To the student?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Very good. Very good. I am really happy that,
yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Really happy that you are following this thing.
Yes, sir.
Because,
yes, sir.
Whenever, please shut off your mic. So, when you share your PPTs or class notes or your learning material to the student well in advance, they get opportunity to learn that well in advance and they can come prepared to their classes. Use class time effectively and efficiently. Deliver lecture in an organized manner so that a student can see the relationship within the topic covered in the lecture. Don't go in a random manner. Highlight main ideas wherever it is applicable. Use instructional aid effectively wherever it is required. Wherever the instructional aids are required, even in the online classes, you can use the instructional aid. The next is be flexible, creative, and open. Try to use a variety of presentation styles and methods. Try to be innovative. If you make the similar type of presentation always, if you give the similar type of presentation to the student, again, it becomes boring, as I have told you in the beginning of my lecture also, that online classes are boring. It is your responsibility to make it interesting. Try to add animation, graphics, etc. in your presentation for better understanding of the student. Break up each period into at least 3 different activities. Even when you are taking the online classes, you try to break your period into 3 different activities. In the first, for example, you can talk about what they have learned in the last lecture. You can tell about what they are going to learn in this particular lecture. Then you can teach your lecture, whatever you have prepared. And at last, you can keep the time for the discussions or for the interaction or for the doubt clearing. Work with different students differently. Try to know your student, because different students have different capacity to understand. Unless and until you know your student, you cannot deal with them properly. And the motivation of the weak student especially, that also will differ. Change approach to meet new situation. Sometime it happens, the situation arises where whatever you have planned, you have to change the approach looking to the situation. So try to change the approach. Go in the same manner which you have already decided. Try new and different ideas periodically. Constantly search for new ideas, approaches, and methods. If you are a good academician, if you are a great academician, you always think a different type of ideas. You always think of different type of approaches or method to keep your student engaged, to keep your lectures interesting, to create interest among the students toward your lectures, to motivate the students, to prepare your content in a better manner. So constantly search for these new things. Open to student suggestions on content, method, or any other. Don't feel ashamed. It is better. A great academician always learn from the student, always take suggestion from their student, whatever they are teaching, the method by which they teach, or any other type of suggestion you can take. Because if you genuinely take the suggestion from the student, your teaching will definitely is going to improve and you will become a much greater teacher. Use individuality and originality in teaching learning activities. As I have told you in the beginning itself, unless and until you use your individuality or originality in the teaching learning activities, the student will not get interest to attend your classes. Innovate and stimulate discussions. Online classrooms, as mentioned before, run differently than traditional classrooms. Initiate and encourage discussions. It can go a long way in terms of how your student feel in class. Encourage participation, much like you would in class. In class also, you encourage the participation. So why don't you do in the online classes also? There are a variety of methods by which you can encourage participation, from discussions to posting lectures to assigning reading materials to monitoring progress, etc. You can incorporate problem-solving situation in your presentation also. In your presentation itself, you can keep certain places where problem-solving situation comes, and at that particular place, definitely some interaction will be there, some discussions will be there. A student will solve the problem. They will feel more engaged. So you can keep the problem-solving situation in your presentation itself prior, well in advance. Develop assessment to reinforce learning. Assessment is very important after a few lectures that to know that whether the students are learning or not. This is the place you can see where they have incorporated the problem-solving situation. Imparting skills and knowledge through a problem-based approach enables learners to relate themselves to a particular situation and act accordingly in a real life. Asking learners to provide solution for problems will help them sharpen their problem-solving skills. For example, here the teacher is teaching the effective sales skill. And what they want to tell, that a salesperson always asks their customers or their prospectives and think about them on certain type of questions. That does the prospect have money to buy? Does the prospect have authority to buy? Does the prospect have desire to buy? Because unless and until a salesperson get these type of questions in mind, he cannot become a best salesperson. He must be able to understand about these three questions before selling anything, before dealing with the customer. As I have told you, that develop assessment to reinforce learning. Assessing learners intermittently is another way of keeping them engaged. Giving a quick quiz or puzzle, appreciating them for their answer, and providing explanatory feedback will keep learners happy and motivated. As I have told you, that after 3 to 4 lecture, you can give them assessment questions, you can give them quiz, but during their lectures also, you can keep the point where you can assess your student, you can ask the questions, and at that particular point, ask the questions, listen to the answers of the student and motivate them, give them proper feedback and appreciate them for the answers. So this will keep the interest of the student in the classes. Now communicate regularly with the student. Maintain a consistent online presence, because communication is essential in the online classroom environment. Introduce yourself and give your student to also introduce themselves. Help bring humanity and warmth into your classroom that online classes usually lack. It usually lack such type of thing, because the teachers does not work on the humanity. They never give the warmth to the student. What is the position of the student? Try to talk to the student. What are their mental status? And then take the classes. Make sure your student know the best method and time to contact you. This is a great responsibility for the teacher. While you are online, when you are sitting remotely, your student want to talk to you. Your student want to clear the doubt from you. So in that particular case, you should ensure that you should be always in communication with the student. You are always online. Not become a professor from whom students become nervous while dealing with them. Try to become a courteous professor with the student. Try to ease this by answering questions in a timely manner and providing plenty of instructions and feedback to the student. Motivate your student. Everyone learns differently, and motivation plays a big part in the learning process. While some students are self-motivated, there are students who are not, and for them, motivation is required. Assignments that are not required may be skipped by the later students. Means you can skip the assignment to the student who are least motivated. Try to motivate them and then again give them assignment so that they work on the assignment with the excitement rather than thinking that as a burden. Think various ways to motivate your student and to get the most out of your class. This may include giving extra point for online discussion or optional assignment. You can use this also, that I will give extra mark to those students who will discuss online. I will give extra mark to or extra point to those students who will give optional assignment. So like this, try to find various ways to motivate your student. Deadline may also help push forward your more unmotivated students. Your goal is to find way to help your student get the most out of your class. And the last is, ask for help and feedback. Your students can provide you with valuable feedback that can help move your class forward. Take periodic feedback and act on it promptly and positively. Believe me, the feedback of the students are very, very useful. With education moving online more and more, your students are now already experienced on online classroom. This experience may help them to inform you on the positives and negatives of your overall online classroom. Beside your student, also seek out and connect with the other online educators. Try to take the feedbacks from your peers. Try to take feedback or connect with other online educators, because education is a sharing field. So these connections could prove invaluable to your online educator development. At last, the overall online education is a wonderful opportunity. The potential flexibility is an undeniable benefit. It is a growing market for educators and therefore an exciting career development opportunity to all of us. You should have the potential to reach a student you would never, could never meet in a physical classroom. Online teaching is not something to jump into, mind you, but it is also really not as tough as it seems. Do your research, learn your methods, and take the lead. Online teaching is relatively new, so there really is not one set way to do it. With some research and preparation, you could find yourself on the forefront of the online educational movement. Thank you.